losing a bit of lane priority. Morgana would be more of the laning support there to have an answer, like you say, to the depth charge. But Kalista, Alistar, given they're going for the tricky gank path, let's watch Snowflower.
They have all their summoners, but they're trying to burst them down, and down will go Nuclear in early.
They have to do more cool stuff in summer. And speaking of cool stuff, they're on this Inferno.
Yeah, they've seen Canyon up on the top side. Hexblast coming in here from Snowflower, trying to make it happen. They're going to knock up Canyon again, and see you later. We will have to wave goodbye one more time. Fate's Call as they continue on and take down a second one. And now Beryl's in a ton of trouble here. He's going to try to re-engage, actually, as he's trying to make the trouble on the other side, but Infernal goes down as well. He didn't even try to push. He was, like, trying to challenge in there. And now Showmaker, without a flash, is trying to do some damage here, but gets assassinated by BD.
More required there. They back away. Prey and Snowfall playing weak side for now. I imagine Prey has the gold for his Way of the Ruined King, but just hasn't been able to.
Totally awful. He's going to be around every once in a while as... Now in the jungle here, Score, he's looking to really teach a lesson here to Canyon, but he gets some low to stop buttons there. But BDD trying to help him out, but the extra kill goes his way and fights on both sides now as Nuclear is going to go down. Kingan trying to go 1v3 over here on the left side, but it's not going to get the reset. 2 for 2 so far as Showmaker leads the charge, but here's Snowflower. Snowflower putting on a show even, as it doesn't look like it's actually going to go KT's way. Down one, able to take down one and the cow on the backside to get
on
an
the re-engage. The re-engage decision was off. The aggressiveness the Score opened it with couldn't be matched by his duo lane.
But definitely a small crack in the door has been opened.
Time to throw Showmaker into topside, taking on Anthony Turret. So these are the trades of objectives that weren't guaranteed. It needs to be Kingan and Snowflower. They are the engaged duo where Snowflower starts and distracts all the ult wasted by Snowflower before Kingan manages to achieve anything. So speaking of skirmish, though.
Score trying to make this one happen again. Goes in for the ult as Beryl is trying to save him. And he's actually going to get away. That's a fast chase to run away. But Beryl is going to have to pay the
price. It doesn't actually seesaw a Baron to the side of KT roster.
Yeah, just the bottom. We'll see if they can continue with some of the good stuff. Okay. As here comes Kingan, just trying to 1v1 on top of Nuggery, draws out the teleport already from the side of Showmaker, who wants to go in with that Realm Warp. Kingan trying to make a move over the wall, but here comes Beryl up from the top side, or Aatrox with a nice dodge here, but you can't dodge that one as he is going to be burst.
Can actually continue to play around this, or whether KT can use what will be double two. The regular flash, as we mention it. KT want to make this game around a Baron. It's Baron turn. Speaking
of
turns.
It is. The ult comes in, but where's the damage from KT? As Dawn are still all full health bars until Beryl goes down. But you can see that bouncing damage now. Look at all the health bars for KT. They're so low. And here comes Dawn trying to turn it around. Looks like they'll just get Kingan on the backside. As everybody else was able to. I guess we're just going for it as they do bait out a flash there from the side of Prey. He's not wasting any time. And now KT a little bit separated, but they're trying to burst down Nuclear. And they're going to be able to do it as Score is going to get into the back line and get that very important kill. And now KT continuing to try to go along here, even without BDD, who distracted the Jays. They are able to pick up three kills. But now they're just trying to get this consolation prize of the cow on the backside. We'll see if they can actually do it. Looks like they should be able to. Snowflower, no summoners, no anything. But
kind of understanding this game one is slipping away from them. Just want to get some cow where they can. So they take down the Alistar. Baron is done.
That Mountain Drake. They already had one for the first Baron. How about a second? So a bit of damage does come out here. Thinking about getting the tier one turret and the bottom tier two. They are trying to make something of their last amount.
Here we go.
But here's the engage, looking for Nuclear again. He is going to be able to flash, but BDD is going to assassinate him in the back line. And that is what they wanted all this time. They're going to get the two. And how about three more for the bonus as Showmaker as well is just barely going to get away with his tail between his legs as KT make the engage happen and should be able to win this game.
You've always got the option to brute force with GAs and this much Wombo engage. Nuggery tries to slide away. He doesn't want to ruin his KDA.
Well, I guess we're going on a safari here, just trying to hunt down the Jace, and now they're going to go for the push. They run out of the Baron. But the dead timer's not super long at this moment. We'll see if they just take the inhibitors and back away.
Pretty sure KT could have taken at least Nexus turrets, but chasing for kills means it might just have to be double inhibitor. Game timer going to go longer. Post 35-minute victories after an early game like this. Nothing to really hang your hat on.
Well, we are going to start up the Baron here with that Kalista. It's going to take a miracle for Domin to get on in here and try to steal this one away, as there you go, the smite comes in, and Snowflower trying to get in the backside is going to get the two-man knock-up here. Depth charge there on a score, but the rest of the damage coming in as another big knock-up comes in from Snowflower. And now we got an Aatrox on the loose thinking about getting in there. But a good spread from the side of Domin as they're just trying to stay alive, but it's interrupted as Showmaker is not going to get out. BDD with another good interrupt there as now Nuclear is going to go down. The rest of Domin should follow. The Super Minion's already pushing in the main base as the TP's going to come out. Nuclear is going to be the last one to die. And KT are going to push in for the victory.
Just desserts go the way of KT there. Good early work allows them to close it out. 37 and a half minutes for game number one. KT rolls, so they play with their food a bit. They didn't get it all perfect, but they get the perfect answer for their fans. They get a victory in game number one.
By hook or by crook, switch here to Galio. Oh. There it is. Okay, locked in.
Galio lane. Mid lane most likely, but it's an old.
4-on-3 for now. You see that score was on a back timing, and Domin Gaming was able to read that very well. Not 100% sure how, but they just go for the Infernal. The timing works out, and they take that buff away. But now Canyon, playing with fire here, is going to get rooted down. Is going to have to use that stopwatch, and they're going to go for the re-engage here, but Canyon is just going to get dunked. But Prey on the backside takes the boomerang to the face. That's going to be a double kill now for the side of Nuclear, and BDD goes down too. And just a shock blast that Nuclear can easily spell shield, and there's no way for KT.
They're not going to be able to play the style they want, as we see a lot of people walking up.
Okay, they're going for the Lux here. That's one person you can pick on, but the shield comes in. They finally get it after Score has to flash in there. Here comes the TP. It's going to get the double taunt here, as it is going the way of KT. It looks like the Showmaker is able to get a ton of damage in the backside, gets a double kill, and is looking for more as the Realm Warp would come in as well. And now it's all to the side of Domin. They're going to be able to pick up the ace with three members remaining.
And that just means they rout KT where they stand. Domin Gaming, who fought back again and again after some horror scenarios for their jungler earlier, make mincemeat of a KT.
Galio's acting a little bit weird. He should know something's up. Immediately going to throw down the World Orb, but he gets out there.
From the Yumi in order to actually interrupt the Ryze. Don't get it. And they do lose a turret, so.
Control of the map right now, so they say, why not? We'll just unlock Nugri up here, see what we can get. It's going to be just the Cloud.
And if you're 3-1 by Akali Ryze, specifically because they've got nothing out of the Jace.
Oh
top.
Boy.
Here we go.
Now we're looking for that Ash in the back line. Can they get it? Yes, they can. A Showmaker, again, is going to be the assassin. Nobody gets in range of the cat. Nobody's going to save her this time. Showmaker, how about a triple kill? We're looking down at 4, as I think they're going to give it on over to Showmaker here, but Galio coming in means that how about a pentakill is a possibility, and it's going to be the fourth that comes in here, and it will be given as the double kill, the unofficial.
Only the Baron should confirm it.
Well, he went legendary 8-0-4 on the back of that unofficial penta.
Game three is kind of a viable thing to do.
Even the shield of the Lux as well, when you're so far ahead, you can really feel the power of it in general. As Showmaker looking for the solo kill here on the Kingen, but BDD is going to put an end to that fun, as now we're going in on to Prey again, as the big damage comes out from the side of Domin. We're just going to look to push them away and end this game fast. They want to go GG fast in the game number three.
When the early game doesn't actually spill over to the mid game, Domin Gaming is showing, just like they did in their first game of the season, that they shouldn't be considered an afterthought. We're getting a competitive series between two teams looking to rise.
Another binding there on the Galio, who is not very tanky, and well, everybody's gonna die as Barrel nearly gets all three of them at the same time. And we're going in. Okay, they want the kill. They're gonna get it on the backside as the triple goes the way of Nuclear. And we are going to a game three.
Sometimes one man has his own basketball. Snuggery this game.
Now we're looking at a Kennen here as the last pick. They say, oh, it's going to be the Aatrox in the top lane. Well, And we're going to throw this cannon up there. Have fun. So this has to once again just accept defeat there.
Cannon in the spot, but score in for the counter gank. He's still here. Doesn't have vision on Canyon.
Okay, they're just going to dodge that one. Now to turn it with the TP. Here we go. The Silas coming on in. But they're trying to turn it around now. A score goes in, but he's going to be punished for that one. It's now BDD going 1v4 here. Snowflower's too low. KT, they got to get out of this one. A Snowflower's going to go down as well. And Showmaker here still on the chase. See if he can get on into this one. Nice little dodge there from BDD, Meteor. As now down one with their lead, are going to push on to the Mountain Drake here. Canyon is going to smite that one down.
Side looking for a kick. There's a lot to like for Canyon in the bot lane.
Looking for it now as the kick into the charms.
Oh, beautiful.
See you later. As it's super clean from the side of position, but BDD has to blow his real flash to get away from that one. But Canyon waiting in the wings here. Gonna get the double knock up here as maybe Domlin went too far. KT able to pick up one, and the TP now coming in as they want more, and Barrel super low gets dunked down by the Aatrox of Smed.
Punished. Nice punishment from KT. Domlin used their teleport. They don't want to give up Rift Terror.
And now Score gonna have to give up his life here as he went a little bit too deep.
Probably a symptom of the double flash at level one for KT. Domlin.
Canyon just really wanted that red buff, and it looks like he may be punished here, but no, Domlin looking to turn it around. Score getting really low, has a nice stopwatch, but now Nuggery in the back line is going to zone everybody away, and Snowflower alone can't do the damage, but
uh-oh.
Here's Feb. The Aatrox is going to get into that back line. Can he do the damage? BDD is going to help out in a big way. The Ignite and the minions will be enough to clean that one up.
It's a very prey or veteran thing to say. Yep, we got those kills. What are we going to do with them? Apparently fight more!
Okay, we're going in again, as that's what Rakan likes to do, but they don't get Snowflower, actually. And prey and score. Sick Wombo once it does come down to it, as Nuclear. He's just been chilling in the bottom lane the entire time as, oh boy, on a ward here's Showmaker, and one more auto might have done it if not for that one. But the flash forward and an extra one is going to be enough as
Barrel?
BDD is able to style on him. But now there's two members of Domlin. Make it three, actually, as they were looking to hand that kill over and a dive in the top lane. But it's a trade over as Nuggery takes out score.
It's a hard one for you, Valdez.
I know.
Everywhere they're finding the observers are like, what's going on here? We have to hire more observers if the meta changes like this. Domlin pushes through the mid lane, pushing, taking down the turret, the usual glacial pace.
Things like, going on at once. You know, BDD goes deep, but then they get the trade kill, and they decide to group up as four as Score gets out of position, trying to go down.
Domlin Gaming thinking better of it. Let's keep rolling. Who's to say we can't import metas? Because this one is feeling like the fiesta people want.
Oh, Showmaker, though. He has a proto belt, but it's not enough to create any distance. Nuclear immediately. And TSS, it looks like, on that one. It's now Smeb going to get in the back line, but here's the Wombo combo. They get the Jarvan, and they get another one, but the Smeb is going to help out in the damage. And so far, Domlin able to turn it around nicely, but can they get out of here alive is the question. Looks like for now, maybe, but hero.
Real. Any fight where they force out the enemy and Zoe and Ezreal are healthy enough to tell tales about
it's his younger brother, Snap. Here he goes into the back line, and a big Wombo actually on top of him. He can't find that kill, and down he will go, and now Snowflower is going to get baited into it as well. You mentioned that duo of Ezreal and Zoe left alive, but it's 5-on-3 now.
It was just definitely a very Snap moment. He just gets in there, but he goes in like he's old Aatrox. He's not, and now Dom will want more.
All right, we're not wasting any time.
He's here!
Into it as Nuggery wraps around from the back and finds the kill. As, oh boy, BDD, what's going on here? He gets the trouble bubble and actually the blasting plant, but the flash on in and the double knockup means that we're going to have an ace, guys. All five members of Domlin are going to survive.
Stuck in there.
Yeah.
Domlin Gaming outplay them. Aatrox's mistake. That spillage is going to burn all of KT Rolster. And
engage on it with the cannon, with the Silas, with the Rakan. You actually do need
Von Nico or something like that. The fact that he's done that and actually pulled off the flanks, not something we usually associate with him, is keeps walking. He's actually a level behind Smeb, who I guess was looking for a team fight. Rogue. Smeb continues to return. All KT can do It's Grin and Barrett. They need to poke before they fight.
They get the trouble bubble here on to Nuguri, who has to Zhonya's early, so they're forcing the fight here. Nuguri going to stay alive, but Downy does go right at the end, and now Nuclear way out of position here. He's going to go down, and maybe KT can turn this somehow as Beryl and everybody is on the run here. Score trying to chase after him, but he's going to get baited into that one, but Showmaker getting pretty low, but now Canyon trying to make things interesting on the prey. Showmaker still alive in the back line here. Dredgeline is going to miss. A kick towards his allies actually means that Showmaker is going to go down. Nice follow-up there from
Prey. Wasted to take a Baron for the team of KT Rolster. A lot of question marks. KT's question at every moment. Sven's going to check with his face.
And that means he's probably going to die here as he is going to ult here. In the end, gets a big knockup, but you just can't build through that one. Possible here for score, but being zoned out by Beryl, and they don't have vision. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough as they get the knockup now onto the back line. A big ultimate there from the side of the Sylas. Takes that one away from Snowflower. They get the double kill. And now the rest of KT just on the run after they give away another Baron to the side of Dom 1 game.
And Zaya brings up the mini web. Can they just win on this push? Feels like a Doom push, Valdez.
Absolutely does. Is trying to read that one. Is not going to be the case. Showmaker with a fantastic Nautilus ult the last time around. But the push continues here as, okay, trying to get that kick. Prey able to be away from that one. Another cannon coming in here that they can use with the Baron. And not too much time on the death timers. They got to go now if they want to. But the fear on the minions by Smeb trying to push him away. As they're trying to engage the big time into the back line of Prey. They should be able to get him here. And Smeb also in the stopwatch just barely trying to hold on to this game. But they're going to target the Nexus and try to end it as fast as possible. Can they, though, as the big cataclysm in the back line, but it's not enough, as Dom 1 will be able to pick up game 3.